during the break, we were talking about that picture, and people here have different points of different ways they want to attack this. Let me start with you, Eric. Do you think that I have the right to take a picture anywhere? First of all, a selfie anywhere, as long as I'm, you know, working, I can take a selfie. Do you think it's a cool thing to do?
See, there are these freedoms and rights we everyone has, but one of the canons of these freedoms and rights is your freedoms should not should not encroach on someone else's freedoms. Mm. So whenever you're doing this, whenever you feel like, hey, I'm exercising myself freely to the world and the way I want, as long as it doesn't encroach on other people's freedoms, you're okay. You go do you, do whatever you want. Take a selfie everywhere you want. But when that selfie can be translated into as offensive to the other people, you have to act. Now, the nurse has, I believe this, because most professional organizations have codes of ethics and codes of conduct. So I believe the code of, I don't know how updated the codes of ethics and conduct
they're probably 1960.
But I believe that could be a breach in one way or another. And this is the thing, by the way, the thing about the law, it was made back then to improvise for today. That could have been a personal breach to the person, it can be directly translated as a selfie, but there could be a breach somewhere.
In the meantime, what's your view about putting condoms everywhere? For example, in a workplace, what are some of those places where you're like, you know what? You can't put a condom at the reception, for example, of New Vision.
Oh, you're talking about like in an open place, right?
Yeah, office place in New Vision. What's the place you're like, I know, you can put condoms elsewhere, but not here.
In some, most hospitals, the condoms are put in the washrooms. So it's easier for the person. But when you put them at the reception, trust me, no one will.
Where in New Vision should we put condoms?
At the reception.
What? We should put, why?
Because we are journalists? We should try it out.
So we put condoms. Well, you heard it say.
Hey. I would really like support that.
why should we put condoms at the reception of New Vision?
Your role models, you know, the people who watch you.
Role,
you know,
models in sleeping around?
No. Role models in saving a life, just like.
First of all, let me ask
say,
you a question. Mm. If I'm a guy and come to you and I have condoms, and then there's me that comes to you that doesn't have condoms, how do you look at me when I have condoms? Do you think I'm a player? Do you think I'm keeping myself safe? Do you think?
Honestly speaking, I would see you as a responsible guy, because you don't know how I am. You don't know
Let me ask
what
Marvin.
I am.
Marvin, like if a girl came to your house, okay, if you met a girl, and for some reason you saw condoms in her purse, would you take her as a promiscuous person?
Depends on what you choose to use. If you choose to use logic, I wouldn't agree that finding condoms in her purse necessarily makes her a promiscuous person. But if you want to use emotions, definitely you're going to ask questions. So how did you get your condoms? Why do you have them? Did I tell you I don't have mine?
Yes.
I believe these two ladies are trying to advocate to run away with those mishaps about having condoms. Most people think like, you having condoms means you're sexually active. You having condoms means you sleep around. You having condoms means you're a malaya. I think we should move away from that narrative. We should look at people who have condoms as people who are trying to be safe at all costs.
Shouldn't we look at people who use condoms as people who have failed to abstain?
Who said, like I said, people think having condoms means you're sexually active. No, it's making sure you're safe at all costs. It's not that you are down and ready to go to deal a Dibala into someone. No, it's not that.
It's making sure you're safe. Anyway, let's go to something else that trended. I saw a photo. And someone took a photo of Bebe Cool's nomination in the Afrimas, and also uploaded something saying that Bobby Wine has been selected to be on a committee on a panel that's going to be talking about African music and how it has influenced people, and they're going to be judging these nominees. Now we're at a point where people are like, hey, mama, Bobi Wine has been chosen to be on a panel, but Bebe Cool is just a nominee. So one is a student of the other. Someone is saying that there's no way Bobi Wine can allow Bebe Cool to take that award because of their misunderstandings here. People are saying, ha, this has to come back home because we have a Ugandan there. This is a Ugandan, of course. What's your take on that whole issue?
Unfortunately, we are so... Most, like we Ugandans on the digital spaces, are so uninformed. You have to realize that the AFRIMAS Music Awards are independent of the panel discussion. The discussion Bobi Wine is going to take part does not in any way influence whether Bebe Cool takes the award or not.
Well, if Bobi Wine was on the panel, and secondly,
first pause. Secondly, Ugandans have failed to appreciate themselves. We have been awarded an opportunity to support our very two own in both stands, to go support Bebe Cool, and he can win that award like Kenzo did on his Facebook, and people came out to lash him. And then part B, to go and support Bobi Wine for upholding that flag of trans, like of showing that you can move from the worst scenario situation in your life to become an opinion leader, on an inspiration to the youth, and an opinion
I think
leader.
He's moving from a good scenario to a best, not worse.
Really. No, actually, he comes from really worse. If you go to read Bobi Wine's story, if they ever write a biography about him, you'd get to experience that this guy came from nothing to where he is today. So we have been awarded this opportunity, and we failed to recognize it. We are just siding to bash because of political differences, because of... mostly because of political differences and the choice.
Totally disagree, Marvin. What's your disagreement?
I understand the argument Eric is trying to make, but let me summarize for you what I want to say in a Facebook post by Kayanja Joel, a friend. Mr. Bebe Cool and the people of Uganda have a very honest relationship. Bebe Cool doesn't pretend to appreciate the plight of the Ugandan people. And neither do the Ugandan people pretend to care about his ambitions. If I can elaborate this, I think where exactly Bebe Cool stands about the life of his fans came out very clearly during the time a certain musician was in prison somewhere after being tortured. And we saw the comments Bebe Cool made. And then we saw the comments Bebe Cool made after they had introduced the OTT tax. He made it clear, guys, I don't really care if you can pay this tax or you can't pay. So when people see him being nominated for this award, it's not that they fail to appreciate a fellow Ugandan, it's not that they are envious, but Bebe Cool has chosen to identify as the guy against them. Why would they want to stand with him?
This is also a guy who started the Golden Heart Foundation.
This is also a guy who
has taken very many actually people for heart surgeries.
I don't want to go into the Golden Heart Foundation because if I don't remember Bebe Cool bringing the accountability for all the
I
fans.
I was actually there.
We have not seen the accountability
he
in
took,
public.
He took the kids
you
from
were
India.
There, yes, but yes. Bebe Cool is the same person who has called the relatives
and someone
and
else. Someone
friends.
Else, someone
let
else
me
can
finish
say,
for
someone
you.
Else can
Bebe
say.
Cool has taken kids abroad for treatment and he has referred to their relatives, friends and society members as cockroaches, my friend.
He hasn't referred to the mother of a kid he took to India.
That's why I'm saying subtle. He has referred to the relatives, the friends and society
subtle.
Members.
I think
it's not about being subtle. So anyway,
someone else could say that Bobi Wine is a guy who came to fight for people's rights and stuff
and
like
I
that.
Agree.
Organize the concert and
I agree.
Ask them to pay for it.
No, it depends on how you look at it. Bobi Wine's music has been consistent from the time he started singing. He has showed that he has the problems of the people at heart. If he decided he wanted to stand for presidency and say these things again, he's going to appear the most credible person that day. Campaigning for an election
credibility is everything.
Now on the issue of people paying Busawara Beach may be Bobi Wine's, but there are bills to be paid. Bobi Wine has a family. He hired bouncers. He hired some organizers. They were paid. Whether they were paid 2 years ago
Ugandans
or 10 months
actually
ago
pay taxes for that
were
guy
paid. Which guy?
Let me come.
They pay for Chagula, Honorable Chagulanyi, not Bobi Wine, the musician.
But there's a narrative that Bobi Wine and Chagulanyi are two different people. But they're two different people sleep in the same bed with the same woman. eat the same food, and I don't understand how they're different. Let me come to you. World AIDS Day is on 1st December, and this year we are celebrating, and we are talking about, we are encouraging people to know their status. I don't want to go personal, but and I don't want you to tell me what your status is. I just want you to tell me how you felt when you first tested for HIV and AIDS.
Well, I've never tested. That is the first thing I should make clear online. I've never tested for HIV, but I discovered that I was HIV positive.
She's abstaining, apparently.
Yes. So
I didn't want you to tell us.
Yeah, yeah, I know, but I have to do this because we're approaching World AIDS Day and people need to know this. So I encourage people to test, though, to really know their status, because for us, we got to know about it when we are still kids and we got it through birth. So, but of course, I encourage young people to test because so many people don't know their status. Maybe someone was born with the virus. Someone acquired it maybe when they are grown. We don't know how. Some might have got it through, because we have cases of guys who got it through surgery. Others got it through breastfeeding. Others in different ways. Others through sexual relationships. So that is why we encourage people to test. And that
some
is the theme.
Some of us don't like to test because we are scared of that time.
Now that
memories will come back.
Exactly.
And
so
like
the first time I tested in my life was when I had a guy who was trying to, you know, vibe, and I was trying to tell him the truth that this is what I am, and he was saying no, it cannot be. So we had to go in. So the first one had to run away. That is clear. A second one came in and still the same approach, and we had to go. He managed to sit in the clinic, they drew blood, and he never waited for the results. That is a second scenario. Another one came in, and he was bold enough, and he came, we waited for the results, and results came in, and I was positive, and he was negative, and he took off after a week. Yeah. And then the final one came in, and I had to give him some time, but he stayed. So yeah, you know, you go through those processes, but then there's always that one person that comes in. That is why we encourage people to test, because now you might find me chilling, you know, I'm in one of those clubs there. I will not lie, I've been in one of those clubs, sipping my own, you know, drink, and you meet, and you're. That is why we encourage people to go with condoms, you know.
Let me come to you. What's your take on Know Your Status? World AIDS Day is on 1st December. How can you encourage someone out there to know their status? Most of us are scared.
Well, I encourage my fellow youths mostly to know their status, because that's the theme of the World AIDS Day.
Why should I know my status? I mean, I probably don't sleep around. I probably have one girlfriend.
No, it's just clearing my throat.
I think it's important for everyone to do that, and for your partner. And I mean, I don't. Everyone lives a different life, so. And since it's the theme, I just encourage that they take this opportunity.
In my own point of view, I feel like you should test for HIV AIDS, because it's not about you, it's about the people you care about. If you know your status, you'd care about the people you care about differently. Until next week, guys, see you on Monday on Urban Today as I bring you the timeline, as well as on Saturday as we bring you the show. Bye.